This time, I'm going to talk about SABR Volatility Model and its calibration in Python. First, let me clarify one concept, implied volatility. In financial market, usually, volatility represents how large are assets prices swing around its mean price. It is a statistical measure of its dispersion of returns. But that volatility concept is different from implied volatility we are talking about here. In option pricing, implied volatility is the value of the volatility of the underlying instrument that when plugged into any given option pricing formula reproduces the actual price of the option contract in the market. So, we have this actual price of the option contract first, and also we have a given option pricing formula. In order to match this actual price of the option contract in the market, we will calculate this implied volatility to fit our option pricing formula. So, implied volatility is the one aspect of the option pricing that cannot be directly observed. Yet, it is the single most important parameter in any option pricing. Another concept is called volatility smile. When you have an option contract, you have this implied volatility at this strike price. And if you go to right, that will be out of the money call or in the money put. And if you go to left, it will be your in the money calls or out of the money puts. Now we observe this implied volatility is not always same constant across this different strike price. When you go to the right, means if the call move to out of the money or put move into in the money, the volatility, the implied volatility will become larger. And similarly, when you move to the left, move to the in the money call or out of the money puts, the implied volatility will increase too. And if you draw a graph, it will look like this. And so, a volatility smile refers to a U-shaped graphical representation of the pattern created by implied volatility of multiple option contracts that share the same date of expiration but with different strike price. Because this shape looks like somebody is smiling, so we call it volatility smile. Then, what is this SABR model for? In mathematical finance, the SABR model is a stochastic volatility model which attempts to capture the volatility smile in derivative markets. The name stands for stochastic alpha, beta, rho, referring to the parameters of the model. So the most important three parameters in the model is alpha, beta, and rho. I'm going to talk about those parameters in detail in the next slide. The SABR model is widely used by practitioners in the financial industry, especially in the interest rate derivative markets. Now, let's take a look at SABR model formula. There are three formulas here. FT is the forward rate. It's instantaneous forward interest rate with maturity large T. And sigma T is the volatility. And the initial value is F0, and sigma 0 is the initial value for sigma. W1 and W2 are correlated Brownian motions with correlation rho. So if we take a look at the formula, the first formula is talking about this forward rate change. And the second formula is talking about the volatility change. And the forward rate change is associated with W1, one of the Brownian motions. And this sigma is associated with W2, another Brownian motion. And the correlation between those two Brownian motions is this correlation rho. There is another parameter, beta, here. Beta is the exponent for the forward rate. It's constant for each forward rate under consideration that determines the underlying distribution of the forward process. Beta can take value from 0 to 1. If beta equal to 0, it produces the stochastic normal model. When beta equal to 1, it produces the stochastic log normal model. And if beta equal to 0.5, it produces the stochastic CRR model. This rho I just mentioned is correlation between the forward and the diffusion processes. And alpha, beta, and rho together can determine the SABR sigma, which is computed internally. Now, let's go to Python, see how can we calibrate SABR model. The calibration of SABR model is quite straightforward. There is a package called PySABR, and there are two functions in this package. One is for the log normal model, another one is for the normal model. In this video, I'm going to use log normal model first. In order to calibrate SABR model, you need two series of data. One is the strike price, another one is the volatility. And after we fit all those strike price and volatility data pairs into this function, we can call this lognormal.fit and do the calibration. Let's run the program. You can see here, this is data for our input. This is strike price here. And then this is volatility here. And after we call this function, we got alpha, rho, and volatility of volatility. There are two functions for SABR model in this PySABR package. One is for log normal model, another one is for normal model. So, what is the difference between two models? Let me use some swaption data to compare them. This file contains the data we use as input. These are the option expiration. This is from 1 day to 30 year. And this is for the tenor for the swaption. You can see it's up to 50 years. And we have a forward rate here, and at the money volatility, and the shift, and beta, and also low here, and volatility of volatility. And in my slide, I call it alpha. It means volatility of volatility. Those are our input data. And then we come back to Python and run the program. You can see this displays the data I input, and the strike price is from -1 up to 6. And then I will produce some graph to compare those two functions. Because this is too big, I save those in a PDF file. So we can come here and get this PDF file. You can see this is for the different maturity and for different tenor. They all have a similar pattern as the at the money. You can see the two functions, like the log normal model and the normal model, basically the same. But when it moves to the left, when the strike price is very low, it shows difference. If you make it larger, you can see clearly. On the right side, it's almost same, although some difference here. But on the left side, when the strike price is very low, it has larger difference. I've uploaded this Python file and also along with this data file to my GitHub, so you can download and run it and test it by yourself. This is why we need SABR volatility model and how you can calibrate it. Please provide your comments and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.